Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
China is in the middle of a raging epidemic with a new and deadly strain of the coronavirus causing the deaths of as many as 106 people and affecting more than 4,500. Most deaths have been reported from Wuhan province alone, the epicentre of the outbreak. As the number of cases crossed 2,700, the Chinese authorities announced a lockdown and advised residents to not leave the city. Among the many stranded are 250 Indian nationals. 20-year-old Maryam Khan, a second-year medical student from Rajasthan, explains how the usually bustling streets are now empty and how they are coping with the grim developments.
I am from Hubei University of Traditional Chinese Medicine. We were informed 1 week before and the coronavirus is very dangerous for us. My friends and me, now we are healthy. No one took the virus. No shops is open. We can't go outside. University give us food, boiled food, Chinese food we can't eat. And they didn't give water. Indian embassy trying the best, but they are not calling us regularly. Chinese authorities, they don't give us reply and they are not trying. The virus is very dangerous for us. We can't go outside. We can't live our life is like normal. We want to come back India. Me and my old friend want to come back India because we are very afraid. Chinese authority, nothing they are saying, like they are no saying, no reply. Me and my friends stay in room. We can't go outside. Over Wuhan city is locked down.
Dr. Manisha Das, a cancer researcher from Assam, says she is exasperated by the lack of information and virtual state of confinement. The Ministry of External Affairs has said that the Indian embassy in Beijing is in touch with the Chinese authorities regarding the safety of Indian nationals in Wuhan. The city will likely remain in lockdown for some time, even as the infection is being reported in countries across Asia, Europe, and North America.
Actually, my husband is doing research on cancer cell in the Huazhen University of Science and Technology, Wuhan, and I'm just working with him. Regarding coronavirus outbreak, it has not been informed directly because biggest problem is the language problem here. Everything they say, everything they write is in Chinese. We just heard from other associates and our foreign groups here. And not such measure has been taken for foreigners by the Chinese authority, actually. We just learned from various social media in the Chinese group that such thing has been done and all this. None of my friend has been tested for the virus because this is actually a winter vacation here and also Chinese New Year, the Lunar New Year. So actually everybody went home to celebrate their New Year and only foreigners were left. We are here because we have to take care of the animals and the fish in the lab. So we are responsible for doing all this while this vacation is on. So basically, because of this reason, nothing serious happened. I could say that. And everything is already closed because of the New Year thing. And now because of the virus, nothing has opened yet. And probably it will not open. Shops and everything is closed, completely closed. And now the authority has closed the vehicles as well. No personal vehicle, nothing is seen. While Indian embassy, yeah, they are keeping a track record of all the students and other people living in Wuhan specially. And they called me personally and asked me whether I want to stay here. And probably they are planning. But as of I know that Chinese government has not given any permission. They said that at least for next 14 days, they will not let anybody evacuate this place. Maybe for serious concern. Maybe health concern, because another important thing is that regarding this virus, it has an incubation period. So the incubation period is up to 14 days. So maybe somebody has a virus in his body, but the symptoms are not shown. So it is also important to look for that. Regarding Chinese authority, I think so. They are more concerned about the Chinese people. They have already built a temporary hospital for a serious patient who are already already attacked, and they are not, because they have given some hotline numbers which are not working because they all speak in Chinese. So it's difficult for the foreigners living here because they can't speak English and we don't understand Chinese. So I'm not expecting much help from the Chinese people. And since I am a doctor myself, so I'm not much afraid, but all my friends and other foreigners, they're really scared because they are unable to go out. And like some of the people have run out of food and other thing also, because all shops and everything are closed, except some few Walmarts and supermarkets probably. Since I have already stocked some food, and because of the New Year thing, many people have already stocked food in their house. That's a good thing because they all know that during New Year, everything is closed over here. And like nowadays, like what my friends and me and everybody is doing is just sitting in the home and just keeping everything clean and tidy and other thing. But my husband has to go out to look for the fish and other thing in the lab. So that is a little bit of concern that we have to take extra precaution. But let's see what else can be done. As of now, this is the situation over here. It is much terrible because terrible in the sense that people are just home arrested. Like nobody is going out. And like once the food is finished, then I don't know how they are going to tackle all this thing. Regular shops are closed and vehicles are not available. No train, no bus. So this is the situation right now. And already many people died, and which is not much reported, because being a doctor myself, I can see the severity. So that's what I can say. Let's hope for the best. And what I can say to the people, that don't panic, stay calm. And since this virus can get contracted from anyone, anything, so people should be careful.
This is Angana Chakrabarti for The Print. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.